This is Session 12, Keyboard Shortcuts. This chapter covered the basics of using Final Cut Pro 10. While there's still a ton of new stuff to learn, you now know enough to be dangerous driving the mouse. Along the way, I've mentioned a lot of keyboard shortcuts that can help you be even faster using Final Cut. At the end of each chapter in this training, I'll provide a summary of these shortcuts. Here are some of my favorites. In the interface, Control-Command-F displays the interface full screen. Command-I imports media. Command-Z undoes the last action. Shift-Z fits the image into the viewer or fits the project into the timeline. Command-plus zooms in and Command-minus zooms out of the viewer or the timeline. Command-A selects everything. S toggles skimming on or off, and Command-Q quits Final Cut Pro 10. When it comes to editing, Option-N creates a new event. Command-N creates a new project. I sets an in, O sets an out. Option-I deletes the in, Option-O deletes the out. Option-X deletes both the in and the out at the same time, or any ranges applied across multiple clips. E performs an append edit, Q performs a connected edit, and the JKL keys reverse, stop, and play, and if you type the keys multiple times, the speed that you go backwards or forwards changes. For trimming and transitions, A selects the arrow tool, P the position tool, B the razor blade tool, T the trimming tool. Command-B cuts all clips at the position of the playhead or the skimmer, N toggles snapping on or off. Command-T applies the default transition to the selected edit point, selected clip, or selected group of clips. And Control-D displays the duration of a selected clip or transition. Other miscellaneous shortcuts include V, which toggles clip visibility off or on, Option-S, which solos an audio clip or selected audio clips, M adds a marker at the skimmer or playhead position, Option-M adds a marker at the skimmer or playhead position and opens the marker dialog. Control-S expands or collapses audio from video without losing sync, comma moves a selected object one frame left, period moves it one frame right. Command-E exports a master file of the current project. And Shift-Command-F plays the viewer full screen, and you press Escape to return. I love keyboard shortcuts because they make Final Cut run even faster. This is why you'll find a list of them at the end of each chapter in this training. This concludes our chapter covering a quick start to editing. Feel free to start playing on your own, but there are tons of new features still to cover. And we'll start with a detailed look at the interface next in Chapter 3. This wraps up Chapter 2, A Quick Start to Editing. My name is Larry Jordan, and thanks for watching. This has been an excerpt of our most recent Final Cut Pro 10 training covering workflow and editing. For the complete version of this online training, please visit our store at larryjordan.biz/store. And thanks